When I was in school, I used to work on my technique away from the marimba. I would do this by playing on the floor. This book is designed for you to take each of the four basic marimba strokes and practice them on the floor to define your concepts of each stroke and then apply it to the marimba. Let me give you an example using double lateral strokes. First exercise I'm going to play for you is a flam. Now, to get started, we have to imagine that the floor is the natural bars of the marimba. Now, to choose a playing height is important. With my mallets on the rug, I'm going to choose the playing height. Watch me do this. Notice that I didn't use my elbow to choose that height. I'm breaking the wrist and my hand stays low. Now, here's the flam. This is actually on page 22 under double lateral strokes, if you'd like to skip ahead for a second. It sounds like this. One, two, three, four. Now, what's important here is not how close the grace note is to the primary note of the flam. What's important is where are my mallets when I'm not playing? The answer is up and ready to play the next note. This is a key component in working these floor exercises. As you work the floor exercises, you want to make sure that each mallet comes to the same playing height. You want to imagine a line up here that you're returning to. Now, you can set that line anywhere you'd like, but be consistent. If you find that you cannot control the playing heights, then slow down. Now, let's take similar exercises with double laterals and put them with both hands. Turning over to page 7, you'll see that there are 8 permutations at the bottom of the page. To get started, I'm going to play permutation number 1. Putting all 4 mallets on the floor, or the natural bars, I'm going to choose my playing height with my wrist. From here, I'm going to play permutation number 1 slowly. Again, notice that the playing heights are consistent across both hands. To go faster with double laterals, the mallets won't actually stop, but they should come back to that same height. The same exercise, a little faster. Let's use a different permutation. Number 4. That's 1, 2, 4, 3. Slowly. Checking the heights. Making sure the heights stay consistent. Faster. Again, notice that the mallets come back to the same height, but they don't stop. We'll talk more about that in the double lateral section. Looking on to the triplet permutations, number 7 is a permutation that goes 2, 1, 2, 3, 4, 3. This is where we'll, again, keep our hands low, choose my playing height. Here it is slowly, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4, 3. Faster. Again, focusing on those playing heights. Faster. If you can't control the playing heights, you can't control the balance in the blend. If you can't control the balance in the blend of the music, you're not going to be expressive. Work slowly, use a metronome, and focus on your technique as you build your confidence. Then apply these exercises to the marimba. Then we're going to apply those with chordal applications, and I'll do that with you in the next section.